It's estimated there are about 3 million shipwrecks worldwide. Shipwrecks can cause damage to natural environments, especially when they still contain oil and other hazardous materials. However, they can also serve as artificial reefs, and they provide habitat for fishes and invertebrates that wouldn't normally have nooks and crannies to hide in. The wreck of the USS Independence is close to our coastline, right off of Half Moon Bay. Our curator here at the Academy, Dr. Gary Williams, in 2016 and 2017, he was working alongside our partners at NOAA, which is the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, aboard the ship, the Explorer Nautilus. And they were using a remote operated vehicle, an ROV, to explore the USS Independence. They were looking at the biodiversity, and he noticed a lot of really interesting, beautiful glass sponges that were attached to the hull of the ship. And so he sampled some of those sponges. Sponges are a very simple in form animal. They're riddled with pores and channels that they use to bring water from the surroundings in through their bodies, and they filter the water for nutrients and small microlife. They also provide lots of habitat for fish and other invertebrates as well, because they have a lot of hidey holes for things to live in and around. Glass sponges are called glass sponges because their internal skeleton structures are made out of silica or glass in sort of beautiful lattice-shaped arrangements. There's evidence of sponges being around about 570 million years ago, so before the age of dinosaurs, sponges existed. You can think of museums as one big network, one big library of life. And these specimens are used by scientists around the world, along with their data, to answer all kinds of questions about biodiversity and life on Earth.